I hear the train a coming. Hi, welcome to another video of Multitrack Cassette fans. My name is Dennis, and this video is a tutorial on how to record and mix down a song on the Tascam Porta05 HS. This particular machine is where it all started for me. I bought this unit in 1991. I was 20 at the time. I was working at a local gas station, saving all my money, thinking one day I'm gonna buy a Tascam 4-track cassette recorder, which happened. And it cost a lot of money, but it was worth every penny of it. This thing has been a reliable companion through the years. I've done hundreds of hours of recording with this. The Porta05 is not the most advanced recorder of all Tascam models, but well, I suppose for sentimental reasons, it's one of my favorites. It's been with me for over 25 years, so how can I not love this machine? The song I'm recording in this video is sung by Johnny Cash, and it's called Folsom Prison Blues. Okay, for track one, we need an acoustic guitar. I'm switching Bus L to go recording on track one. My master fader is in the gray kind of neutral area between 7 and 8. I plug my mic that's in front of my guitar. I plug the mic into channel one, and I'm sliding the fader of channel one up to the also to the gray neutral area. And now I'm hitting some notes, and I'm slowly there's a little dirt in the fader. Well, it has to be all the way up. Now I'm positioning my mic just past the sound hole of my guitar body, and I'm for this song I don't need too much bass in the too much low end in my guitar sound, because there will also be a bass guitar and also an electric guitar for the rhythm. So we don't need all those instruments to be sounding too bassy. So I'm turning this a little down. Okay, that sounds about right. Then I'm hitting record and play and pause. Let's hear if that's if this is a good level. Rewind to zero, and let's hear on the tape cue. Well, that sounds okay. Okay, let's do our take. Later on, when we record the electric guitar, there'll be an intro. That sounds like this. But we don't have that right now, so we need when we want to record that later on, we have to have some kind of count in. One, two, three. Okay, let's have a quick listen if that was any good.
1, 2, 3.
Okay, it's I'm satisfied with that. If you have your monitor function set to Q, then these will be the volume knobs for your individual tracks. So these are very important when you record and listen to the tracks that you have already recorded. Okay, the guitar sounds nice and very busy. Okay, let's rewind, and then we can record our bass guitar on track 2. So I'm switching off the record function of bus L. So this is you can see the green area, which means bus L is safe. And then we're going to plug our bass in our amp. You can directly inject it into your input, but my personal opinion is recording bass through an amp and put a microphone in front of the amp, it makes your bass sounds better. It sounds more natural. Okay, I'm putting the microphone amp, the microphone preamp level to zero, to line level, which is zero. I put my microphone in front of my bass guitar amp, and we're going to record that onto track 2. So we have to switch bus L to record on track 2. The recording LED is lighting up, it's blinking, and I'll hit a few notes on my bass guitar to hear if there's to get some sound coming in. You hear this fader is a little dirty. Well, if we don't touch it during recording, that shouldn't be a problem. Too much. Okay, this level seems right. And then I'll have tape cue not too loud, because I want to hear my bass. So let's have a listen to that. To that mix.
1, 2, 3.
Okay. It can be a little less. Again, so this now I'm only setting a right level, so I can hear the backing track and my bass guitar at the same time. I need to have a nice balance between those two for my performance.
1, 2, 3.
Let's listen to that. Tape cue of track 2 for bass.
1, 2, 3. Thank you.
Okay. Okay, recording on track 3. I'm neutralizing this EQ again. It didn't matter for recording the bass, because that was bus right, which would have been these two. But now I'm going to record on track 3. So that'll be bus left again. So I need to neutralize these two. I'm going to record a guide track. So later on, while recording my guitar track, I know where we are in the song, because it's there are some unexpected early moves in this song. So first I'm going to record a guide track. So we'll be recording over this later, but for now we need this track for orientation. Okay, that was kind of that wasn't recorded too well, but as I said earlier, it's just for a guide. So I'm putting bus L left to save again, and I'm recording the real guitar track on track 4. So I can listen to my guide on track 3, which I just recorded.
1, 2, 3.
Okay, let's hear what that sounds like. Because I'm not sure if I can get it any better. 1, 2, 3. I guess I'll have to be satisfied with that. Recording mode is both buses are set to save. And now the first thing I'm gonna do is record the intro of the electric guitar. The intro I have to play is something like this. Check. Okay, that's that sounds okay. Now for my lead vocal, I've done something a little special. I use my MXL large diaphragm microphone, and it needs 48 volts of phantom power, which is not available on most 4-track recorders. So I'm using an Art Studio V3 voiced valve amplifier. I thought it would be nice for my lead vocal to be recorded with a large diaphragm. I'm neutralizing the EQ for track 3 again. And because the microphone has been preamplified, I can leave this at line level, because the microphone preamp has a line level on its output. And one other thing, because I already have an intro, a guitar intro on track 3, I need to punch in right after the guitar intro. If you want to know any more detail about punching in and out, you can check my other video on that subject. So I've connected my punch foot switch. Instead of recording and play, I'm just pressing play. And when the guitar intro has been finished, I can press the foot switch.
One, two, three.
I hear the train a coming, it's rolling round the bend, and I ain't seen the sunshine since I don't know when. I'm stuck in Folsom Prison, and time keeps dragging on. But that train. I hear the train a coming, it's rolling round the bend, and I ain't seen the sunshine since I don't know when. I'm stuck in Folsom Prison, and time keeps dragging on. But that train keeps rolling on down to San Antone. When I was just a baby, my mother told me, son, always be a good boy, don't ever play with guns. But I shot a man in Reno.
I think the vocal, it still has a little distortion. It has a little edge, but I think that's okay for this song. Okay, we're ready to mix our song. There'll be no bouncing because, we don't need any more tracks. It's a nice and simple song. In the original song by Johnny Cash, there's a real present tape delay, and I'm trying to copy that with my Lexicon MPX500. I selected a tape slap preset, and I fiddled around with some delay times and the high frequency roll off to imitate the sound quality of a tape echo. It shouldn't be too bright. I connected that to the output, the effect send of my recorder. I plugged that into the input of the Lexicon. And the output of the Lexicon goes back into the effect return of my Tascam. Since we're mixing down our song, I switched the monitor switch to remix. My tape cues can be turned all the way down. The effect return is about 4. And I prepared a little mix. In a moment you'll hear the intro of the guitar, which is quite loud, so I have to put it down a little. And then when the vocal comes in, I can set it to maybe 7. The guitar and the vocal have quite a lot of tape echo, as well as the rhythm guitar, the electric rhythm guitar, and I also put a little on the acoustic guitar. None on the bass. Well, most of the time, especially in country, you don't need any effects on your bass guitar. So let's have a quick run through our mix.
1, 2, 3. I hear the train a coming, it's rolling round the bend, and I ain't seen the sunshine since I don't know when. I'm stuck in Folsom Prison, and time keeps dragging on. But that train keeps rolling on down to San Antone. When I was just a baby, my mother told me, son, always be a good boy, don't ever play with guns. But I shot a man in Reno just to watch him die.
Maybe I can remove all the tape echo on the acoustic guitar.
Whistle, I hang my head and cry.
Well, I don't think we really need a tape echo on the acoustic guitar. I'll solo the track 4, which is the electric rhythm guitar. So now you hear the rhythm guitar with the tape echo. I'll crank it down. So you hear the tape echo is adding a lot of character to the sound. I find it quite addictive to play around with delay times. With the bass. Okay, let's prepare our mix. Let's get the levels right for the intro and the vocal, which are both on track 3.
1, 2, 3.
Level 5 is okay. If level 5 is okay for the just below 5. Let's have another take.
1, 2, 3. sunshine
and the vocals
I don't know when
are stuck in the average level of the vocal should be 7, just over 7. And there are some weak points and there are some louder points which I can at which I can adjust the level manually.
When I was just a baby, my mother told me, son, always be a good boy, don't ever play with guns. But I shot a man in Reno just to watch him die. When I hear that lonesome whistle, I hang my head and cry.
Okay, once again. I notice I put the vocal at around 8 and in the second verse. So maybe that's that goes for the whole song, except for the intro, of course, which should be just below 5.
1, 2, 3. I hear the train a coming, it's rolling round the bend, and I ain't seen the sunshine since I don't know when. I'm stuck in Folsom Prison, and time keeps dragging on. But that train keeps rolling on down to San Antone. When I was just a baby, my mother told me, son, always be a good boy, don't ever play with guns. But I shot a man in Reno just to watch him die. When I hear that lonesome whistle, I hang my head and cry.
Well, that's it for this video. I hope you liked it. I hope it was useful. If you have any questions on recording this or other machines, please leave a comment in the comment section below. And in the meantime, have fun recording, have fun mixing, and see you next time.